you've come a long way, baby. Yet in business, it's still too often a man's world. But there are women trying to change all of that by creating mentoring programs, which provide women with advisors, role models, and the inspiration to spread their wings and finally fly. This is going to be very helpful for any of us wishing to make a change in our lives. So please welcome Helen Cohen, Director of Career Development at Goucher College. And with her is Nancy Aaron, mentoring participant, and Linda Harris, a trade analyst from the Italian Fashion Center. Thank you, ladies, for coming. All right. Let's start off with a basic question here. What exactly is mentoring? Linda, you start.
Okay. Mentoring is aiding and assisting, let's say, people who are college graduates or people who are just finishing their programs at a college, helping them understand what awaits them in the corporate world, giving them ideas and some direction that maybe the career counselors cannot give them at that time.
So in other words, you have a position in a company, a good position, and someone starting up in a business, let's say in the same field, could come to you and say, tell me about what I'm going to have to know, for instance, or can you give me some tips on how I can get ahead? Is that what mentoring is?
Well, it's part of it. I think that we are there to give direction to, as I said, people who maybe are undecided. They have majored in a certain area, and because they haven't had, let's say, corporate experience or a lot of work experience behind them, want to really know what is out there, what awaits them, what are the things that they may have to, I mean, skills that they may have to hone,
right,
or you know, different areas that they might even know exist.
Right.
All right.
And so we're there for that.
Nancy, you are a student at Goucher,
yeah,
correct?
Correct.
Now, what are you majoring in?
Communication.
Okay. You have a program at your school that you go to someone who is in communication?
Well, what I did was filled out an application.
Right.
And then from my application, I put down my needs, what I wanted to get out of a mentor. And then Helen would try to match me up with someone she thinks would work.
Right. What have you learned from the program so far?
Well, I learned another aspect of communication. I've had previous internships in public relations, marketing, and my mentor is more in the production end of it. So I learned another facet.
Has it helped you? Do you feel it has?
I do, and I got an internship out of it.
You did.
And from this mentorship program, I took another course at college I wouldn't have chosen to take.
Yes. Helen,
yes.
Now you are sort of in charge of the mentor program at Goucher College.
And I'm
correct?
Assistant director, not director, but thank
okay.
you.
But I just promoted you. You see, being with me is so simple. Yes, I'm a mentor.
That's
what a mentor is. Okay. If I was, let's say, a woman
mm-hmm.
in out in America right now, and she's watching the show,
mm-hmm.
and she wants to start in some field,
mm-hmm.
how would she go about finding a mentor and contacting them and learning if she even wanted to be in that business or how she could get ahead in that business?
Mm-hmm.
Can you answer that?
Well, if she graduated from a college,
right,
she could go to the career development office of that college to see if indeed they had such a program.
Right.
If not, and if she could not find help that way, she may want to look into some professional women's organizations. There are many
okay.
in the large cities, small cities, tucked
like,
around corners.
Give us a specific, like what kind of an organization would someone right now listening call?
All right, if let's say somebody's interested in the Baltimore area, there's a group called Executive Women's Network.
Okay.
In the New York City area, there's a group called AWED. Those groups would certainly help women find mentors if that's what they wanted to do.
Is it important that we do this? I mean,
yeah.
I know that in the corporate world, forgive me, men, the men still hold all the power, really. I mean, it's very unusual for a woman to become a CEO or head of a corporation unless she really started that business. I'm sure that there are some, but very few. So we sort of get to a certain level and you call it a glass ceiling. You can sort of see the big picture, but you can't really get beyond it.
Mm-hmm.
Having this network of women helping women, does it help?
Yes, I think it does.
How?
Because it creates the old boy network that maybe we never knew about before.
What do you mean by old boy network?
Well, I mean networking, giving ideas and information as a sisterhood, let's say, of women out there with corporate experience to women who are in college and also housewives who maybe, you know, have a few skills and are coming back into the working world.
Yeah.
And I know that I never had a mentor, and I understand what it means to be one. And I really wish that somebody 15 years ago gave me the kind of direction and knowledge that I can give now to other people coming to see me and consult with me.
Great. Okay. What?
I just wanted to add, too, that at Goucher, we are now a co-ed institution. We were a women's institution for 100 years. We recently went co-ed, and the mentorship program has opened up to men.
Mm.
And we have some men participating in the program and who appreciate it very much and have benefited from it also.
All right. Do you all understand what mentoring is, I hope? All right. When we come back, we're going to find out more career information for all of you and get some questions from our audience. Okay? Thank you, ladies. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Be a part of Attitudes and join